Okay, picture this. You're running $100,000 in paid media every month for you, your company, and you want to make sure that you're getting the best bang for your buck. You want to make sure your Meta ads, your TikTok ads, your LinkedIn ads, your Google ads, wherever you're running ads are converting. You're getting a good CAC, a good cost, customer acquisition cost, and you're trying to drive those costs down, those CPCs down. Okay, what do you do? Well, creative, right? Creative is the variable. You want to make sure your creative is speaking to the audience and giving them what they need. So you spend your hard-earned money not only on the paid media itself, but on the creative to drive the traffic through, the click-throughs into what is typically a landing page, right? But the problem is a lot of companies don't pay attention to where the customers land. They think a category page, a PDP, a product page, that is going to suffice and that is going to do everything that's needed to convert that customer. But oftentimes what happens is somebody clicks on the ad and they get to a landing page that doesn't load very quickly. They get to a landing page which has a weird image or a hero image that doesn't really describe. And with the attention spans we have that are equivalent to a gnat in today's day and age, we don't have the attention spans to be able to figure it out, especially when it's an advertisement. You've got nanoseconds to impress somebody and to try to pull them along in the customer journey. And a landing page is the place that you will earn that hard-earned customer who clicks through from an ad. Okay. And it doesn't just go from ads. It goes for emails. It goes for PR. It goes for guest posting and backlinks and anywhere else that you're acquiring a customer, podcast sponsorships, YouTube sponsorships, influencer marketing. Landing pages are the secret sauce that not enough people talk about when talking about advertising. Landing pages are the things that will convert customers, not the ads. The ads are top of funnel. The ads will get them in the funnel, but they're not going to convert them. So how do we structure our landing pages? It's really not rocket science. You can go out and you can find all sorts of templates that you can use to create magnificent landing pages. There's plenty of landing pages out there. We use Unbounce. That's a pretty good one. We custom design landing pages sometimes. But here is the secret sauce to making a landing page that works. Step number one, as soon as they get to the landing page, have under 10 words as your headline with something incredibly captivating for that specific audience. Whoever you're running that ad to, if it's 25 to 35-year-old women, if it's 55-year-old men, if it is city goers, if it is country goers, people that live in cities, people that live in countries, or the countryside. Okay, whoever those people are that you're targeting with that particular piece of creative, make the landing page speak to them. This includes that 10-word headline. Now, I say 10 words, it's obviously flexible, but the shorter, the better. The shorter the headline that can make the maximum impact, the better. Okay, now headline. Next, have a key visual that connects the dots from the ad that they just saw to the landing page and what you're going to offer. So it should align because our brains don't really do well with drastic changes. It makes us analyze things too much. So if we've already analyzed the ad and the creative and we're like, yeah, this is super interesting, I'm going to click on it, I want to see an extension of what I just saw. So try to make sure that the ad image or video or graphic or whatever it is extended on the landing page. Those are the two things that you're going to want to make sure that they see first. So those need to be above the fold. That means the hero section. That means basically you don't have to scroll to see these things. And the third most important thing to have right in this section is a call to action. If there's only information, you risk them getting distracted by their phone. Somebody just texted them. An email that pops up, right? Somebody just walked through the door, whatever it might be. If you have a call to action right there that is very easy for them to click on, or if it's an email opt-in, you know, adding their email, something super quick and easy so you don't lose them. That's the key here, right? So 10-word or less headline. key visual that is an extension of the ad, and a call to action, all right within the above the fold section where they don't have to scroll. Okay, those are the first three things. You need to have those on a landing page. I'm going to show you some examples in a minute. Actually, just one kind of key example of a poor landing page and another key example of a good landing page. So you can see the difference. But after you address the hero section, when they scroll down, you've got to make sure that that you're meeting the user where they are. So I'm going to discuss mostly top of funnel, brand new awareness, right? Somebody who doesn't know what they're clicking into and how to make it work. And the very next thing you need to do is pack that screen full of social proof of the problem that you're solving, right? So this is the dream scenario, not always the case, especially if you're a startup, but if you can pack the next section with testimonials or case studies that shows how you've addressed the problem with other people, you're almost all the way there, right? If that person is ready to spend money, they're going to spend money on you. The more social proof you can put in this section that shows that you're able to solve the problem. That's the best case scenario. If you can't provide that social proof, then the next best case is to have a simple section with imagery that explains how you're going to solve their problem and anything else that you can do to ease their nerves. Awards, clients you've worked with, education that you've had, places you've worked, whatever the thing is, they need to see that you're trustworthy before they're going to continue to scroll. So hero section, social proof section, and then get into the details. What are the benefits that they're going to get? So the third section down, what are the benefits if they end up moving forward and buying or purchasing or signing up with you? Those are the most important things on a landing page, right? You don't have to go crazy. There's a lot of people that say, you know, you need to have crazy long sales pages. You know, sure, they work sometimes. They don't work like they used to because, again, going back to we don't have the attention spans, but those long pages are not necessary. What is necessary is quickly showing somebody that you are legit. And those three sections are going to do it. Okay, let's take a look at a few examples, shall we? All right, so I'm over here at Google, and I'm going to go ahead and type in best running shoes. Okay, let's take a look at this first ad that pops up. Runner's World, one of the most well-respected media companies in the running space. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to look at this ad. Okay. So if I'm looking for the best running shoes of 2024, 2024 is top running shoes. Okay. I want to know. Runner's World is telling me what are the top running shoes. These are 30 top models that we're loving right now for the road, trail, and race day. Find the right running shoes that fits your budget and needs. See our top picks, ratings, affordable. And then we got some other links here. Treadmills, cross training through shoes. Okay. Don't love that they're kind of diverting your attention away from shoes, but okay. Spring sale, up to 45% off running shoes. All right, that's a pretty good one here, but let's just click on the title and see what we get. Okay, so we get here, and what do I see? I see tons of menu items, and I see sub-menu items that don't have anything to do with shoes. So what happens with my gnat brain? Okay, I look at this. Well, first, images are going to catch my attention first. So right now I see just a bunch of trashy shoes, to be honest with you, right? I see just a bunch of shoes. It looks like they were like, you know, my closet or something like that. So it doesn't get me excited about the best running shoes. All right. But beyond that, then I look up here. I got all these other places I can click. So here's the problem with this landing page is that you're giving somebody so many other options to leave before you've even shown them 2024's best running shoes. Okay, so I'm going to scroll one time. That's what happens. Okay, so I scroll one time, and if there's even a glitch with the scroll, I'm going to think something is wrong because it's not showing me anything. There's no words, there's no title. So it kind of looks like it's wrong if my finger slips. All right, so I'm going to keep scrolling. Oh, okay, now we get to the article, the best running shoes of 2024. I'm just actually wanting to see what this looks like. Even worse on mobile. Okay, if this Now, they might have a mobile version of this. I don't know, but it's even worse on mobile. So I'm scrolling down. I just see it fade away. All right. So this is a pretty terrible landing page. Okay. Now I get in here. Best running shoes of 2024. Okay. Not bad. You know, it could be better, but it's not bad. It's aligning with the ad that I just wrote. These are the top 15 models we're loving right now. So that's actually weird because the ad said 30. This says 15. Maybe a mistake. I don't know. Okay. So I'm scrolling down. Editor's note. We reviewed jump to best running shoes, daily trainers, race shoes, stability. Okay. I can jump to the ones I want. So let's say I'm just looking for trail running shoes. Okay. Whoa. So that I wasn't even actually scrolling. What you just saw there was an auto scroll all the way down to that section. So that, again, that's going to lose people. Because A, if their internet is sticky and it's sticking and glitching, they're going to be like, what the fuck is happening to my screen? And probably click out, right? Okay, so now I'm here and I see trail running shoes. I see one. And so this maybe is the one that they want me to buy. I scroll down. I see ad. Okay, so the presentation on this landing page is pretty terrible too because it shows me one at a time. What I would do is have them scroll laterally or horizontally so that if I get here, I've got like number one, number two, and I just scroll. Also, it would keep it so that I don't have to go all the way down this ridiculously long page, all right? So that is a pretty poor landing page, all right? It's kind of lazy, but I get why, right? So Runner's World probably runs tons of ads all over the place. And they're a media company. They're not exactly a product company. So they're trying to drive traffic to the article and then they make money off of all the affiliate links that they have in here. But they can really do a much better job, which it would be basically when somebody clicks on the ad and they get here, I have the title right here. I have maybe one section where it's visuals, like this section is road. This one's trail, this one's walking, this one's whatever, and I scroll and I click the one that I want, and then it brings me into the site where then I can see all of the nicely organized shoes in that category. All right, another option is if you want it at one page, then you click in and it scrolls down to that section. Again, I don't love the one pagers where it's got like a table of contents and you click it and it goes down because again, you risk that people's internet isn't going to support that auto scroll. Okay, so let's go back out here. Okay, the next one. Let's look at some other ones. Okay, so after Runner's World, so they're spending the most amount of money because they're on top, and they have the worst landing page, so not great. Now I scroll down here on cloud. So these are one of the most trending shoes right now. They're pretty high end. They're like 150 minimum. You see these everywhere. If you go to New York City or Austin or San Francisco, you know, any of the big cities, you see these all over the place. So let's see what we get. So best running shoes, it just says on run on clouds. Not bad because they probably know that people know their brand now. I don't hate it. I don't love it either, but okay. Try our shoe finder today, engineered for high performance and complete comfort. Easily find the right shoe for you. Okay. Click. And let's see where we were at. Road running shoes 20. Immediate pop-up. Okay. Gonna click off of that. Run easy on asphalt, conquer. Okay, yeah, I don't love this either. All right, it's better than Running World because it gets right into shopping. Okay, shopping. I love their shoes, by the way. They're just so unique, right? So again, they could probably get away because they've got the brand to get people through the clutter. But again, right here, they didn't lead to a landing page. They landed to just a shop page. Also, their menu is a little, it's, it's very busy, right? They got a yellow menu over to the right side. They got a sub menu over here to the left side. They've got road running shoes. What if I want trail running shoes? So not a good landing page. It's actually not a landing page at all. It's just a category page. So again, kind of lazy. They just drove you to a category page where I have to kind of keep shopping. And if I don't know on, then I, you know, I've got problems because I'm like, what is going on here? Like, I want trail running shoes. So now I got to go back and shop for trail running shoes. All right, let's keep going down. All right, the almighty Nike next. So Nike's got one of the biggest brands in the world. They don't have to try as hard. But here we go. The latest Nike running shoes. Everyone is an athlete. Latest innovations to help get more from your run, however far you go. Gear up at Nike. I got to say, their copywriting is pretty weak for being Nike. But let's click in. Let's see where we're going. Okay. Still a category page, which is fine for Nike because, again, everybody knows Nike. And what I do love, though, is that you can see the shoes. This is the only page we've been to where you can actually see the shoes right here. So I can get right into shopping. So, okay, this is good for Nike. Good for you. And I got a side menu here where I can filter. I do have a top menu up here. That's okay for Nike because people know Nike. But for a lesser known brand, I would limit their ability to click around too much up here. And I would keep it strict to the filters. So they're already basically shopping. All right. And let's see. There's latest Nike. Okay. Sponsored running warehouse, best of 2024 running shoes, expert staff picks. Our in-house shoe experts give their list of the best running shoes for each category free. Copywriting's fine, actually, right there. It's just direct to the point, gets cut off there, but not a big deal. Okay, I'm going to click in. The best running shoes of 2024. Okay. Not bad. Let me move this out of here. Not bad. Not a huge menu, kind of simple. They do have a menu over here. If I click, you know, they got their side menu. The best running shoes of 2024, pretty straightforward. There's no distractions or very little distractions. They got a call to action up here if I want to do it. Yeah, phone number, support, and a big search bar right here. So I can go in here and I can search trail running or something like that, right? So if I don't see what I want right here, I could search. Most people aren't going to do that. So let's just scroll down. Okay, scroll down. Image, how we made our picks. Too much text here. Ooh, running warehouse, too much text. Okay. How they did it. Yeah, way too. Nobody gives an S about this. Okay, not great for desktop, but probably fine for mobile. Huge shoe here. Huge shoe here. Yeah, again, not a great visual representation. Okay, so let's find a good landing page, shall we? Okay, we're going to go best running shoes for men. Enter. Okay, what do we got? We got Running Worlds again. We're not going to click on that. We already know what's there. Let's check out Brooks. Okay, we get to Brooks. All right, Brooks, still a pretty good brand name. They are just driving it to a category page again. Okay for Brooks because most people know Brooks. Here's what I love about Brooks, though. This landing page. This is a good landing page. Okay. Also, I like the delay. I like that the pop-up doesn't appear right away. In fact, there's studies to show that when a pop in today's world, right? This was different 5-10 years ago, but in today's world, if a pop-up automatically pops up before you even get a chance to see the page, people are going to click off it. So, word to the wise here. Don't have your pop-up on landing. Give it a delay. Give it a 5 or possibly even a 10 second delay. Okay? Or else people will just click off automatically. You got to give them a chance to like comprehend what they're seeing and then be like, ooh, I like this stuff. And then pop up and say, do you want an extra 20% off? They don't want 20% off if they don't even know what they're buying yet. Okay. So here, this is awesome. They've got, not only can I shop right here, but also they've got sort of the information that I might want. So they've got the visuals here. I can see the price. I can see everything right here. But then also on the left-hand side, welcome to your first and last stop in the search for great running shoes for men. Find the perfect shoe for you. Okay, I can get my shoe finder here if I don't find what I need over here. I can search men's running, road running shoes, men's walking shoes, men's trail running shoes. I can filter right here. So Brooks, ding, 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 you are the winner for best landing page for best running shoes, or in this case, best men's running shoes, because you give me all the information right away. There's not a lot of lag. There's not a lot of issues that could pop up with my own internet delaying things. If I'm a new person to Brooks, I get to see what I need to see. I get to quickly scroll through. Do I like what their shoes look like? Yeah, I like what their shoes look like. Okay. Also, another point for you right here. I didn't see this till just now. We've got a little call to action right here. Got Damon Brown, run, rinse, represent. So they got a collab right here in case I like this, if I want to support a cause and do a collab. And then I can keep shopping, keep shopping, keep shopping. Or I go over here and I'm like, you know what? I really like these trail running shoes. I'm going to click men's trail running shoes. And it's going to bring me to just the men's trail running shoes. Ooh. By the way, really like these. I got a pretty bold personality, so this is great. Save 15% on High Point apparel, getting me in even closer. So Brooks, you're definitely the winner. All right, so here's where we're at, everybody. Landing pages are the thing that is going to make your paid media work. It is. Of course you need good creative. Of course you need good ad targeting. But when they actually click through, if you don't have a good experience on the landing page, you are going to lose a high percentage of people. If your site is slow or it doesn't load properly, you're going to lose a high percentage of people. If it's confusing or has too much text, you're going to lose a high percentage of people. If you don't have a short headline, a visual, and a call to action right away, you're going to lose a high percentage of people. That's it. Hopefully it was helpful. Subscribe if you like this, and I'll see you in the next video.